Earlier this week, big news from the Vatican. Pope Benedict announced his retirement. The 85-year-old cited health concerns as the reason for the decision to leave his post in less than 2 weeks. The last time a pope resigned was about 600 years ago. So what does this mean for the local Roman Catholic Church and for the conservative traditions Pope Benedict was known for preserving? Area Roman Catholic woman priest Reverend Patti LaRosa joins us now to discuss this more. And thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
And to begin, what were your initial thoughts when you heard the news that the Pope was retiring?
Well, that was a big surprise because obviously I've not seen it in my lifetime. And to hear that another Pope had resigned, everybody went to their books and looked it up. Well, yes, it was about 600 years ago. And believe it or not, it is in canon law, which is the church's governing laws, that a Pope could resign, a bishop could resign, a priest can resign, a pastor can resign from their post if they feel the need to. So it was surprising, but oh, it has happened before. Mm-hmm. And here it is happening again. And I applaud him for taking the decision to do that after prayerful consideration, after spending time, as he said, repeatedly examined my conscience before God. And that is a wonderful example that he gives to us.
Now, you represent a very unique group of priests. You're a member of a group called the Roman Catholic Women Priests, which started in 2002. You were ordained in 2011 in full apostolic succession, which is, by the Roman Catholic Church. Yet you're not acknowledged by the Vatican because you are a woman.
And yes.
In fact, in 2008, during Pope Benedict's term, the Vatican formally declared a policy of excommunication for women like you who completed ordination. So that being said, what does this news, the Pope's retirement, mean for women in particular who believe they have a similar calling?
I think he has given us a stunning example of what we have ourselves gone through over the past decades. I discerned my own call to the priesthood 25 years ago and have spent time repeatedly examining my conscience before God, praying, struggling, saying in my own Italian way, couldn't you make this easier? But I tried being an Episcopalian. I went there for a few years thinking, well, God, let's join the Episcopal Church. We can do it here, right?
And you found out it wasn't right for you.
Wasn't right. Didn't fit, like trying to put my 7.5-foot medium size into a size 6 shoe. Just didn't fit. And I realized when I was at Union Theological, completing my Master of Divinity in a non-denominational seminary, I was Roman Catholic. And my call was through the Roman Catholic Church to the God that I believe in was calling me to be an ordained priest in the Roman Catholic priesthood.
How many female priests would you say are in the Rochester area?
I think there are 5 or 6 in the Rochester area. There might be as many as 80 in the United States, or maybe 100, but let's include Canada. There's one in Latin America. There are several in priests and bishops. There are women who are bishops also. Totally in the world, about 150.
In terms of the female priests here, you mentioned about 5 or 6. Mm-hmm. What type of support are they receiving from the local church? I know you were with Spiritus Christi Church. Now you have expanded your work throughout Western New York. Mm-hmm. But what type of, were you embraced at all? What was it like?
I was embraced by people who think and believe like me that all are created equal before God. And if God is doing the calling, we need to listen and humbly acknowledge the fact that God is calling whoever God wants to. As far as the traditional church, the organizational church, there was no embrace. There was no conversation. There was silence. And that's painful. There was an article written about us when we were ordained deacons here in 2010, talking with people who, of course, who were for it, and people, they had someone who represented, I think, the United Conference of Catholic Bishops. I'm not sure of her name, or else I would mention it on television. But her quote was, you don't just wake up one morning and decide you're going to be a priest. And that was hurtful and dismissive and condescending, because none of us woke up that morning and decided, hey, I think I'll be a priest today.
Reverend Patti, what do you believe Pope Benedict's retirement means for the local Rochester area Roman Catholic community?
The community is already in a transition period because Bishop Clark resigned. There is no one to replace him yet, so the bishop from Syracuse is overseeing. So there's transition already. I hope that a new bishop will be appointed for the Rochester Diocese, but big changes are afoot. By resigning, Pope Benedict has shown us that nothing is carved in stone, that even something that didn't happen for 600 years could happen again. With a new pope being elected, new feet in those shoes and wearing the white, who knows what can happen? Now, all of the cardinals that are going to vote were appointed by Pope Benedict and his predecessor, John Paul II. That's how old they are. There's no one earlier than that.
And what do you think that would mean then for women like you who would like to pursue the service and serve for the Roman Catholic Church, to be a woman priest?
I think we will continue to show our communities and the community at large that this is a model that the church could pursue, where all people are equal, where we recognize that God can call whomever God wants to the priesthood, and we need to listen to God speaking in our consciences. And I say thank you to Pope Benedict for ending his reign of public service with speaking of his conscience. And in 1961, when he was present at the Second Vatican Council, he wrote this quote in a commentary on a document about the church. Over the Pope as the expression of the binding claim of ecclesiastical authority, there still stands one's own conscience, which must be obeyed before all else, if necessary, even against the requirement of ecclesiastical authority.
And what does that mean?
It means you pray, you discern, and you listen to your conscience, because that's where you and God intersect. And even if your conscience says, I need to break a rule that the church has, you follow your conscience. And I say thank you, Joseph Cardinal Ratzinger, for these two bookends, embracing your own career, which has been very conservative, but you spoke about conscience in the beginning, you spoke about conscience at the end. The primacy of conscience, where the active living God speaks to us and calls us, not always to obey the status quo, but sometimes to turn things upside down and shake it up a little bit.
Well, thank you so much, Reverend Patti LaRosa, for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And stay tuned to WXXI News for continuing coverage of Pope Benedict's retirement as his successor is named.